It's always a pleasure to be here because the Fantastic Three forces me to think out of the box. What the hell am I going to talk about? And so when I got the invitation, I said, there is such a great amount of people talking about the net, and so I decided to talk about what didn't really work out, you know? So I said, consequences is just what happened. This is printed just outside a school outside of Melbourne, where I was a few years ago. And I was looking at that sign, and I said, yes, this is a great thing to teach our children. Stop. Look. Listen. And think. By the way, we tend to look more and listen less, you know, because we are losing our capability as animals to listen to dangers, okay? But this is exactly what I did. I tried to stop, look what's going on, listen to signal, and think. And this is what I want to share with you. Due to the color of my hair, I can assure you I was there when most of this thing started. And we were confident. Do you have audio?
Bye.
Yeah. Actually, we have to remember that the people who made all this possible, after all, were the kind of guys who were at the summer of love. You know, the age of Aquarius and Che Guevara and all the dreams about a wonderful world facing us. That's us. So we believe that the network should have bring more democracy, more knowledge, more collaboration, inclusion, everybody, you know? And free time. Free time, yes. Thanks to mobile devices, we could have more free time. We were, after all, believing that technology would bring more harmony, you know? But then we started becoming uncomfortable with dissonance. Something that was not sounding as we expected. I think mostly because at a certain point, quite early actually, economic issues came into place and started prevailing. And we were talking less about the great potential of the internet and so, and more how to make money out of it. If you talk today to some of the start-uppers, as they call them, why are you doing it? To change the world? No, I want to make a startup. I want to be bought by Amazon and make tons of money, and then I will. It's a completely different vision, actually. Well, so what happened is we invented nice words. Sharing economy, what a fantastic term. Disintermediation, social everything, social here and social there. Smart cities, smartphones, smart you name it. The gig economy, we are calling this a gig economy. People is pedaling with fun to take pizzas around, you know, you can see. I think the best term we invented was happy hour. Have you ever been to a happy hour? Do you see happy people? I think it's a concentrate of sadness and desperation. You know, they laugh, but it's not happy. But we use those fantastic terms to tell lies. Did we lie? Well, not quite. You know, they were sweet little lies.
Tell me lies, tell me sweet little lies.
My mother used to call them holy lies, you know, bugie sante in Italian, you know, little lies that you use to make, you know, life easier, not to say things you're not able to understand right now. And so, yes, I think we lied. We didn't want to tell that the things were not going the way we expected, the way we dreamed. And so we use words to say those lies. Well, some of those lies were not that sweet, because after all, when labor generates poverty, when the evolution of the web is not generating wealth to workers, but you know, generates real poverty, those lies are not as sweet as they should be. So, I think one thing we should do is call the things by their name. Sharing economy? No, it's rent. I mean, you rent a taxi, you rent an apartment. It's not sharing. Well, sharing is something else. I share my home with you, and then that's it. I don't want to be paid for. Sharing is a different concept. Use the web so you disintermediate the relationship. What is Booking? Actually, what is Amazon? It's a new intermediator, more efficient, different, but it's not what we thought, that it was total disintermediation. Actually, we are calling social things that are driving us to exactly the opposite. They're making us more individual, you know, typing on our Facebook, you know, more thinking about ourselves than about the others. Smart cities, I think if we are not careful, we are dehumanizing the environment. We are using smart. Smart means, yeah, something intelligent, but the risk is very high. The gig economy actually is piecework, okay? The more pizza you give, the more money I give you, you know, and there are years of fighting all around the world about the workers' right, you know, to be treated differently. So I think the first step is, let's call the things by the name. So, when we see this, we hear a dissonance. What is a dissonance? It's something that, you know, we perceive as strange. So the first thing when you find a dissonance is to recognize it, and then not to ignore, because we tend to ignore dissonance, or we want to twist it and make it harmonic. Well, let me talk to you about one of my last love stories. Are you familiar with Igor Stravinsky? No, who's familiar with Stravinsky? One, two, three? Well, I know, it's hard. But I hope you change your mind after my presentation. But exactly that was my mood when I discovered that I knew nothing about one of the greatest musicians of last century. You know? A musician that the equivalent in painting is Picasso, because Stravinsky did every possible technique, every possible musical genre, and I knew nothing about it. So I decided, and I bought the entire collection of CDs. Some of them are still very hard for me, and I said, okay, let's start with the easy piece, you know. But I think that I learned something. about dissonance. I think you're familiar with this. Are you okay? Go. No? Wait a sec. Go. Susu, pump the volume, please. You cannot dance with it. This is 1913. Puccini was still alive. That Walt Disney in the 40s used this to make Fantasia, meant to be shown to kids. You know? What a great vision he had. Yes, the sound is so hard, the rhythm is so intense because Le Sacre du Printemps describes a pagan rite that comes from the old Russian tradition. Music had to be like this, okay? So, we tend to react badly because after all, we want, like in fairy tale, you know, that, and they lived happily ever after, okay? This is what we expect from music. This is what we expect from stories. We expect that everything is fine. And so the dissonance is disturbing. Dissonance is something we tend to refuse. If you've seen Fantasia, it's when the dinosaurs are arriving. It ain't no Mozart, you know? That's not even a Levy, you know? This kind of dentist music that you use to make people calm, or the elevator music, you know, that tend to cope with your claustrophobia. This is claustrophobic music, maybe. So, dissonance is not wrong. It's not out of tune. There is a little difference between being out of tune and being dissonant. It's like when you are not able to paint and you say, oh, well, I did an abstract painting, you know. I'm like Pollock. I just put, you know, painting on the floor. I'm Jason Pollock. Or in music, it's typical way to know how to play. I do free jazz. You cannot even stay on time with a waltz, you know, but you say you're doing free jazz. No, the dissonance is necessary. This is what Stravinsky teach us. It's necessary because it forces to keep your ears open. It forces you to keep your mind alert. Listen, you know, it's not something you just play while you do something else. I want your attention, okay? Take this little sample from L'Histoire du Soldat, 1918, so. Listen to this kind of music is like when I go hiking with my son. I mean, you cannot walk in the mountain just like Alice in Wonderland, you know. You have to look where you're putting your feet, you know. You have to mind your step. Everything you do, you have to pay attention to it. This is what is dissonance will help you to. You know, you expect something and something else happen. And in this differential, your brain sparkles. What's going on? Okay? So, again, it's necessary. It's necessary to describe the truth. And it's not just notes. This is going to be difficult, but I'll try. Well, when we hear a dissonance, okay, our ears are kind of disturbed. But the most disturbing thing that Stravinsky does is with tempo, is with rhythm, okay? Again, you cannot dance with it, okay? Stravinsky is absolutely loved by percussionists because it's so hard to stay in time. And again, reality is not plastic, perfectly modeled, you know? We have continuous things that happen that we don't want to happen. We want to put everything under control and the reality doesn't fit our Excel spreadsheet, you know? So the piece I found to explain this is where Stravinsky, in rehearsal, talks to the pianist how to perform a piece.
One, two, three. C'est pas clair. Vous avez one, two, three, one, two, three, one, two, one, two, three, one, two, one, two, two, one, two, one, two, three, one, two, one, two, three, one, once more.
One, three? Two. Three times in one. I think we have a lot to learn, because dissonance takes us out of our own comfort zone and tell us reality is what it is. Okay? It's where we start from. Like they've said, maybe we want to change it. Maybe we have a goal. Maybe we have to find ways in which, but we don't have to lie about where we are. So, what are the consequences I see? Guys, it's going to be a long walk. There are no shortcuts to achieve what we were dreaming about. More democracy, more knowledge, more social, more you name it. It's going to be hard, long, and tough. Education, everybody talks about education. It takes time. You cannot pick a zip your son and say, please, okay? I pick a zip you, so then I unzip you next week and you're gonna be graduate because, no, it's not gonna work like that. Knowledge takes time. And that's something that we have confused, because is speed a value? Tell me, is speed a value? I don't think so. Well, we have to do the things without, you know, wasting our time, but maybe why not? After all, wasting your time in a cafe in Trieste is not a bad idea. But we thought that speed per se was a value. And so if it takes time to achieve a result, it isn't good. We have to make it quicker, faster. No. That's not a good way. We have to tell the truth. I know, people don't like bad news, okay? So if you are running a project and it takes 6 months, you have to tell to your customer, it's going to take 6 months, maybe more. No, I wanted earlier. Sorry. It's going to take 6 months. Okay? Instead of inventing terms and inventing words and inventing sweet little lies, be courageous. Tell what's going on. The word courageous comes from Latin, cor habeo, I have a heart. And I have a heart that tells me that this is the right things to do. So, again, instead of looking for smart cities, I'd like to see an attitude towards, let's have hearted cities. Let's put not just intelligence, but passion. And about social, this is a picture I took in Bari Vecchia. If you've ever been to Bari Vecchia, it's a fantastic place. I saw those ladies, you know, sitting outside and chatting, you know. And when you meet them, they refer to you as ciao signor. So there is the confidential ciao that builds the relationship, and the signor that gives you respect. So I think the synthesis of this ciao signor tells us that there is a real social environment that tries to include and establish a relationship instead of just people chatting and exchanging messages, okay? So what? So what's my conclusion? What's my pill? My pill is we are supposed to change the world for them, not for you, not for me, but for them. And let's keep on looking for harmony. And dissonance will be just the path, what we are looking for. Thank you.